हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम ऑन द टॉपिक डेथ ऑफ अ पार्टनर। प्लीज रिफर टू पेज नंबर 202 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक। फर्स्ट वील रीड द सम। वी आर हैविंग थ्री पार्टनर्स, राजेश, राकेश एंड महेश, एंड दे आर द इक्वल पार्टनर्स। And the balance sheet is given on 31st March 2019. And below the balance sheet, we are given that one of the partner, that is Rajesh, that is the first partner, he died on 30th June 2019, and the following adjustments were agreed as. Now here, what is the difference between the retirement and death is, retirement is normally on the convenient date, but death is not having convenient date, and that is why a partner may expire during the year. So we have to take care after how many months the death has taken place. So here Rajesh died on 30th June, that is he died after 6 months, sorry, after 3 months, April, May and June. So after 3 months he expired. And then the following adjustments were agreed. Number one is furniture is to be adjusted at its market price. Land and building is to be depreciated by 10%. RDD is to be created at 5% on debtors. And the most important is the profit up to the date of death. That is the important adjustment in this sum of Mr. Rajesh is to be calculated on the basis of the last year's profit, which was 1,80,000. For that we have to prepare the working note. So I have already prepared the working note. So I am going to explain you. Okay. Now as usual, just like a retirement, normally whenever we are asked to prepare ledger accounts, we are preparing the profit and loss adjustment account, partners capital accounts and the new balance sheet. So in this sum we are told that prepare profit and loss adjustment account, partner's capital account and balance sheet of the continuing firm. So we have already prepared this. So that is the step number one. And then step number two that we have to follow, transfer the items of balance sheet, liability side as well as asset side. So let us proceed. We are given the capital of Rajesh, Rakesh and Mahesh. So in the capital account on the credit side, I write by balance brought down. Capital is 5 lakh, 2 lakh, 2 lakh. So the first person's capital is 5 lakh. Second partner's capital is again 5 lakh. Sorry, 2 lakh. And third partner's capital is again 2 lakh. So 5 lakh, 2 lakh, 2 lakh. By balance brought down. So we have to show on the credit side. Then we are having creditors, bills payable and loan. And in the adjustment, nothing is given about the creditors, bills payable and bank loan. So again, we are going to write this in the balance sheet in the outer column directly. So sundry creditors 90,000. So I'll write here sundry creditors 90,000 outer column. Then we are having bills payable 60,000. So bills payable 60,000 outer column in the balance sheet. Bank loan is 1,50,000. So bank loan 1,50,000 outer column. So our liability side is over. Now on the asset side, we are having land and building 4 lakh. So we write in the inner column because there is an adjustment. Then furniture there is an adjustment. Debtors there is an adjustment. And stock, there is no adjustment. Furniture, land and building. Okay, so land and building 4 lakh. So I'll write here land and building 4 lakh inner column. Next, we are having furniture 3 lakh. So furniture 3 lakh. Inner column. Then we are having debtors 3 lakh. So debtors 3 lakh inner column. Next we are having stock 1 lakh. So stock 1 lakh rupees we'll write to the outer column, and cash also we'll write to the outer column because there is no adjustment related to cash. So cash is 1 lakh. So in the balance sheet, cash is 1 lakh. So we have completed the transfer of asset sides. Now we have to do the adjustments of revaluation of assets and liabilities. So we'll do the first adjustment. Furniture was to be adjusted at market price. Now the value of the furniture is 3,40,000. So furniture's new value is 3,40,000. It means there is an appreciation. So appreciation of 40,000 in the value of furniture. So second effect I'll give here in the profit and loss adjustment account, buy furniture account 40,000 on the credit side of profit and loss adjustment account because there is an appreciation. Land and building is to be depreciated by 10%. So land and building is depreciation, 10% is 40,000. So outer column it is 3,60,000, and in the profit and loss adjustment account on debit side to land and building account, that is again 40,000. Okay, now provide RDD 5% on debtors. So debtors minus RDD at the rate of 5%, that is 15,000. So outer column it will be 2,85,000, and 15,000 will write on the debit side to RDD account because RDD is created 15,000. So our adjustments related to revaluation of assets and liabilities are over. So we'll close now the revaluation account. So here the total on the debit side is 55,000, and the total on the credit side again we'll write 55,000. So the difference is by revaluation loss, which is transferred to three partners. Which are the three partners? Rajesh Capital account, then Rakesh Capital account, and Mahesh Capital account. So the difference is here 15,000, and this is to be distributed in the equal ratio, so 5,000 each. So this is the loss which is distributed to the partners in the equal ratio. So we'll be debiting the partner's capital account, second effect, to profit and loss adjustment account, 5,000 each. Now our next step is treatment of goodwill, but it is not given in the sum. So our fourth adjustment. Now here the question of profit arises because on 30th June we are not preparing profit and loss account, we are not closing the books of account, but we have to give 3 months profit to the partner. Which partner? Rajesh. Okay, so we have to do the calculation. So on the average basis, as per the information given in the problem, we will find out what is the profit, that is share of profit due to the partner. So here we will write Rajesh share in profit is equal to last year's profit. In our problem we are given 1,80,000 last year profit into profit sharing ratio. All partners are sharing equally, so 1/3 is the share of Rajesh, and he expired after 3 months. So 3 upon 12. So the proportionate amount in proportion to his share of profit and in proportion to the period, the total amount is 15,000. Now this 15,000 should be given to the partner who is expired. Okay, so we have to give 15,000 to Rajesh. So we'll credit Rajesh by, so we'll open a new account which is known as a profit and loss suspense account. So by profit and loss suspense account, 15,000 is given to Rajesh. And the second effect of this, because we have not prepared the profit and loss account, we have not prepared the balance sheet, so the second effect we should give on the debit side of balance sheet. So here we will show it, and then we are going to adjust it in the normal profit and loss account. Profit and loss suspense account, that is 15,000 that we will write here. Okay, and now we have to close the accounts one by one. So profit and loss adjustment account is already closed. First we are going to close Rajesh account because Rajesh expired. So we have to find out what is the amount due to Rajesh, and it should be transferred to his legal executor's account. Okay, so we'll transfer to his legal executor's account. So the total here, ₹5,15,000 for Rajesh. So ₹5,15,000 to Rajesh executors. Loan account. To Rajesh executors loan account, 5,10,000. And this particular 5,10,000 we have to transfer to the balance sheet. Here again we'll write Rajesh executors loan account, and that amount is 5,10,000. So 5,10,000 in the balance sheet, Rajesh executors loan account. So when we'll pay, then we'll do the necessary entries. Okay, now for two other partners, we have to find out what is the balance here. 2 lakh is the total. 2 lakh is the total. Here also the total is 2 lakh. So 195 is the balance left out, 2 balance carried out. And in the balance sheet we'll write partners capital accounts. Who are the partners? Rakesh and Mahesh. So the amount is 195 each. 195,000. 195,000. So the total is 3,90,000. So we'll do the total of the balance sheet. So the total of the balance sheet is 12 lakh rupees. So we got that the balance sheet total is 12 lakh. Rajesh executor's loan account is 5,10,000 and partner's capital left out is 3,90,000. So this is the way we are going to solve problem on the death of the partner. You can solve this sum at your home and you can do the practice. Okay, thank you.